Hi YouTube, my name's Michelle and I am currently the author of the ExByEx series. Now today we are going to take a look at the very first blog post that I wrote, which is on Event Grid. I'm trying out a new series titled ExByEx. One thing I've noticed about myself is that whenever I learn something new, I like to use analogies to help make it click will stick in my head, and so I thought, hey, maybe someone else might also benefit from these weird, quirky, fun stories and examples that I make up to help me learn, and so I've decided to share some of them with you. The first topic is, what is Event Grid? Well, the actual documentation says it's the event routing service on Azure. Typically, if you are building event-driven applications, your application might emit events that needs to be received by some other application or vice versa. Event Grid allows you to specify your application as the event source and some other application as the event handler, and automatically route events emitted from your application to the specified event handler. For the non-technical folks, what does this mean? Imagine you want to catch up with a friend over coffee. How do you initialize this? You might send them a text message or message them over a social media platform, or you can do it in the old-fashioned way and send them an email. Sending this message means you have emitted an event saying, hey, let's catch up for coffee. And the action for this event is to go and get a coffee. Usually, there would be more communication back and forth to arrange a date, a time, and a place. Your friend might respond with, hey, sounds great. Let's meet at Coffee Grid next Tuesday at 9 a.m. Now let's say this message got accidentally sent to someone else with the same name as you. They could have a guess at what the context of the message meant, but they might not know the location of Coffee Grid or even be in the same time zone. In a way, applications communicate with each other in a similar way through emitting events and messages. An application would emit an event saying, this thing happened. Event Grid routes that event to some other application who knows exactly what Coffee Grid and Tuesday 9 a.m. means. That other application will then perform some action, and you can rest assured knowing that event won't get accidentally delivered to some other application with the same name. So what does any of this have to do with this weird and highly designer diagram I drew? Well, when I first looked at Event Grid, I thought, wow, this is a lot of terminology to wrap my head around. So I came up with a story to help distinguish between publisher, topics, events, subscribers, etc. So I started a company, a very prominent company that has no name. This no-name company has a board of executives and a pool of workers that act as assistants to the executives. Rather than having a one-to-one executive-to-assistant relationship, the company has a strange policy where the executives have shared access to the assistant pool resource. Now, each executive have their own task list in which they must write all their tasks to. The company then handles assigning those tasks to an assistant. The executives trust that all their tasks will be handled effectively by the assistant. The company purchases a software called Event Grid to handle all the task assigning. The company, in this case, represents anything that published to Event Grid. In Event Grid terminology, they are known as the publisher. The company comes up with the CEO task list, the CIO task list, the CFO task list, etc. These are known as topics in Event Grid. So the CEO sends their tasks to the CEO task list, the CIO sends tasks to the CIO task list, etc. The tasks in this case represent events. And so naturally, the sender of those events are known as the event source. From the assistant pool, let's say John gets assigned to handle all the tasks in the CEO task list. So as soon as a task lands in the CEO task list, John gets notified he has to do something. In Event Grid terms, John is a subscriber and he has subscribed to the CEO topic. That's known as an event subscription. Now, John may not always handle the CEO's task. His contract with the CEO's task list might expire by the end of the year, and this is called an event subscription expiration. John may also subscribe to handle the CIO's task and the CFO's task at the same time. Like I mentioned before, it doesn't have to be a one-to-one relationship. Let's say John, Sally, and Meg all subscribe to the CEO task list, but John might only handle the CEO's laundry task, Sally only handles the CEO's coffee requests, and Meg only knows how to schedule meetings on behalf of the CEO. If the task comes in as a phone call, it gets directed to John. If the task comes in as an SMS text message, it gets directed to Sally. If the task comes in as an email, it gets directed to Meg. This is known as filtering in Event Grid. The phone call, SMS message, and email are known as event types. So you can use Event Grid to filter events to event handlers based on event types. When John gets notified of the laundry for CEO event, he will forward that request to a laundromat. In this case, John is the event handler for the laundry for CEO event. When John makes a request to the laundromat, he becomes the event source and emits a dry clean these 5 shirts event to the laundromat. So now the laundromat is the event handler for the dry clean these 5 shirts event. When John sends the dry clean these 5 shirts event to the laundromat might be closed. What Event Grid will do in this case is redeliver the event until the laundromat receives it when it opens up for business again. So there you go. If you ever need to explain Event Grid to someone, start by explaining how the CEO of a no-name company can always get a clean shirt first. Thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoyed that video. Check out my Explain by Example blogs on medium.com/@michelle.z for more. Oh, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment below, as all YouTubers have to say.